friends. I am attempting to do this live off my computer, so hopefully everybody can hear me. If you can hear me, if you can leave a comment or something just to make sure that it is not fuzzy. I'm trying to avoid that. I'm using my computer today. So before I get all set up, I want to make sure that we can hear. Sweet. We can hear. All right. Hi, friends. I'm Taylor. And normally I have the description of the classes written down, but my computer decided that it wanted to delete everything before I got started. So today's practice is a second attempt at the yin for relaxation number two that we did on Tuesday. And we're redoing it because I would like you to be able to hear what we're doing, and I would like you to be able to relax. So hopefully this will be a better version, especially without all the white noise. So the props that you need are two blocks, one bolster, and possibly a blanket. So the blocks look like this, regular yoga blocks. If you don't have blocks, it will be a little bit difficult in certain poses, but it's totally fine. You can use a stack of books or pots and pans or just something that is sturdy and a little thick. Bolster looks like this. If you don't have a bolster at home, that's okay. You can use a pillow or a couch cushion or anything that you like. Just make sure it's nice and squishy. And blanket is just regular old blanket. You can also use a towel if you don't have any blankets at home, or a rolled up jacket or whatever. Just something that's soft and squishy. These aren't a requirement, it's just something that may be helpful as we move through the practice. So we're not focusing on any particular space in the body today. It's just more about softening down and relaxing. And for those of you that are new to yin is all about getting into joints, the ligaments, and the connective tissue of the body through stillness. So we'll use our props for gravity and gravity to build up the space for us to soften in. There should not be any pain at any moment. If there is pain, stop, back out of the pose, adjust, and then go back in. If there's some discomfort, that's totally fine. Try to sit with it, try to breathe through it. And make sure that you're listening to your body. You are the boss of your body. You're the only one that can feel what you're feeling. So if something doesn't feel right, adjust. Sound good? So let's get to it, yeah? So we're gonna start off on our back. All you need to do is lay down, no props needed. And we'll take a full body stretch. So your arms are a little wider than your mat, and your legs are a little wider than your mat. So we're in a big X shape. And from here, you'll take your right foot over to your left and cross your left ankle over top so that both of your feet are on the left side of your mat. Then you'll take your right hand over to your left. You can walk your shoulders and your head over as well, so that both of your arms are on the left side of your mat. Keep your right hip down. And we'll breathe through the side body. You shape kind of like a banana, a little crescent. Let's do a little bit of grounding here. Relax your jaw, soften your face. Let's get through the breath. Feel in your body, notice any sensations, any spaces of tension, or anything else that draws your attention. Know that we're not judging anything that we find, just looking for awareness to best serve your body.
Notice where your mind is. If it begins to wander at any moment, don't get frustrated. Come back to this space. Back to your body. And back to your breath. And now notice your breath. Can you feel your belly rise and fall? Can you take your breath a little deeper? And finally, shift your awareness to an intention. Something you'd like to manifest through the practice. Or simply recognize the reason why you made it to your mat today. If you don't have an intention for yourself, my intention for this practice would be to breathe. So in spite of any challenges with the poses, in spite of any limitations with my body, in spite of my mind wandering, all that matters is that I'm breathing in a deep, intentional way. Whether you created your own intention or accepted mind, you can next three exhales, send it out onto your mat and out into the space that you're in. One more deep breath for yourself. And settle in. Throughout this practice, and my practice is what I teach in Yin, I don't talk a whole lot because I like you guys to focus in on the sensations of your body and focus in on your breath. So I'll give you a few reminders every now and again to check in with your body or to breathe. But most of the time I'll be just quiet. Let's take three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. Then come back to center. Bend your knees. Take your feet a little wider than your hips. Let your knees rest together and bring your hands to your belly. Just for a little bit of constructive rest. So take a few breaths here. Take one more. And from here, we'll come back into that full body stretch. So arms and legs a little wider than your mat. This time you'll take your left foot over to your right side, cross your right ankle over the top. So that both of your feet are on the right side of your mat. Do a big yawn. Then walk your hands over to the right side as the left. So that your hands are on the right side. Make sure your lift stays down. Breathe into your left side body. Notice the reminder. Take a sip of your breath. Take a few moments of rest to feel about this pain. After your third breath, go back to center. Again, bend your knees. Take your feet a little wider than your hips. Let your knees fall together. Bring your hands to your belly for just a moment of constructive breath. If there's any movement that you need, now's a good time to do so. Then when you've accomplished what your body needs, we'll come on up. Going right over for a heart bridge. So this is where the blanket might come in handy. So it's not a requirement. So your shoulder has a little shoulder dip right before your collarbone becomes prominent. So rather than placing your blocks straight up and down to where they'll press on the collarbone, take your blocks diagonally so that way it just in the shoulder dip, and it's a little bit more comfortable for your body.
So I've got my blocks placed diagonally.
I'll come down to my belly. Blocks are under my shoulders. Not pressing into my collarbone. Move my arms back, palms up,
and then I'll rest my forehead down.
And if you'd like to use the blade to support your forehead, that is always an option. And you can take any one of the three heights. So lowest, medium, or tallest. And the tallest is pretty deep. So I wouldn't recommend it if you're feeling like your shoulders are super tight.
To find the space that works for you.
And then we're flopping down. And this is a great space to feel your belly trapped into the floor every inhale. Then flopping back every exhale. If you can allow your body to soften just 2% more. We take our three cleansing breaths here. Let's see if your breath goes your head, move your block. Find whatever movement your body needs. And then maybe the comfort that your body needs. We'll come up. And we'll do seven. So we'll do one at a time. Just for the sake of ease and comfort. Some of us can do full saddle at once, but it's nice if we do one at a time, in my opinion.
So you will take one block, medium height, and place your bolster on top. You will take your second block, place it at the base of your bolster, and you will sit in front of it with your knees up to your side. So for those of you that practice other styles of yoga, like yang yoga, vinyasa, and all that, you should do hero pose. So you sit down on the block with your left leg then off to the side. And we'll do this one at a time. So extend the right leg forward. And if you have hypermobile knees like me, dipping the blanket up under your knee will make it a little bit more comfortable. So I've got a blanket under my right knee. From here, all we'll do is lean back so that we're resting on the bolster. You might need to lift your hips and adjust. And then you can rest down. Your arms can be off to the sides or on your belly or wherever it suits you best.
Three cleansing breaths to close out this pose.
Your third breath, gently lift yourself up, send your hips over to the right, so next to your extended leg. So remove the block, adjust your left leg so that it's now bent towards the bolster. Your right leg will bend off towards the side, so we're in this zigzag shape for deer. Bring one hand to either side of the bolster. And come back.
If you want to take it a little bit deeper, you can remove the block from the outer edge of the bolster. Not a requirement, just an option. And this isn't a super challenging position, so I challenge you to focus a little bit more on the back. Feel the space that is created when you breathe deeply. Feel the space along your side body. Notice where your mind is. Focus in on your breath. Take a three cleansing breath to close out this pose.
Use your breath, back to the other rise,
and find whatever you need, your body needs. I'm going to move my bolster to the other side just so you don't have to look in my butt. You don't need to move anything. And we'll do the other. So we'll put the block back to the base of the bolster. Sit out front so that the right leg is bent. Your left leg extends out straight. And again, if you have hypermobile legs, knees grab. It's helpful to have a blanket under your knee. And we'll move back. You need to lift your hips and adjust. And then rest. Notice the quality of your breath.
Your belly rise and fall with your breath. Take a free cleansing breath here to close out this pose. Breathe your breath. Softly, gently rise. Send your hips over to the left. Next to your left. Remove your block. Bend your right knee so that it is near the bolster. Left leg bends off to the side in that zigzag shape. Bring one hand to either side of the bolster and hold. If you can allow your body to soften down just keep your foot more. Okay, three cleansing breaths to fill the abdomen full. A few deep breaths, but we gently rise. Find whatever movement your body needs. And our next position will be comfortable.
Feel it, extend your legs out straight. If you know your hamstrings are particularly tight, you can take your blanket underneath your knees. Now I keep the blocks. To support my bolster. And all we'll do is melt forward. You don't need to pull or force. All you need to do is be soft. And melt.
I'll take three cleansing breaths to close out this pose.
Into the breath, softly gently rise. And I'm giving you the Shavasana. No, child's pose first. Just seeing if you were paying attention. What I was going to say was our next pose before Shavasana. Here we are. So we'll take child's pose. I like to take my knees wide just so I have space for my amendments. So I have space to breathe. But if it feels better for your body to have your knees together, that's totally acceptable. So option one is to just reach forward with your hands reaching out, forehead down. If there's a lot of space between your chest and the floor, you can use your bolster and place it between your knees. Like so. Because that's the cozy, especially since we're doing gentle relaxation. If your knees start to get sensitive, you can take your bolster between your feet for a little bit of support. And if the tops of your feet start feeling a little sensitive, you can roll up your blanket and place it under your feet for a little bit of support. Like so. So finally, adjustment that works best for your body. Now I'm going to take the bolster off. I'm feeling extra soft and smoothy.
I'm going to take our three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. Let's do a third breath, softly gently rise.
And now we will actually go to Shavasana. You can take it however you'd like.
Just the final resting thing. If you have your arms out by your sides, let your palms face up. Lift your chest, tuck your shoulder blades in towards your spine so that you're flat on the floor. Let your legs be nice and wide and let your feet fall wherever they choose to land. And tuck your chin in towards your chest just slightly so your neck is spacious. Feel the close contact between your body and the floor. Feel the earth rise up to support you. Let the only movement of your body be your belly rising and falling with your body. Know that you are worthy of this moment of stillness and relaxation. Allow yourself to enjoy it. This moment 15. As you begin to close out of the Shavasana, bring your awareness to your breath once more. Feel your belly rise and fall. Broaden your awareness to include your entire body. Notice how there's a little bit more softness and ease throughout. Bring the corners of your lips upwards. Raise your thumbs across each of your fingertips. Roll your wrists. Spread your toes and roll your ankles. Then rock your head side to side. And if it feels right, take a full body stretch. You can choose to stay as you are for another moment, or if you'd like, gently roll to one side. And then when you're ready, come on up to a comfortable seated position with your hands at your heart center. Let's take one more deep breath together, in and out. Bow to yourself. Send yourself some gratitude for making it to the mat today. And send some love and compassion to your very strong, very capable, very beautiful body. Thank you for making your way onto your mat today, for sharing your practice with me, and allowing me to share mine with you via this video. The light in me loves the light, and each and every one of you. Namaste. All right. So I hope you feel soft and smooshy and wonderful and relaxed. And hopefully I will see you again soon.